Today is June 26, 2013. You're watching Speedrun, and this is the Polygon New York office. The first piece of DLC for BioShock Infinite is out today, but it's not the DLC you are looking for. The Columbia's Finest pack adds a bunch of items and bonuses for Booker to shoot and shock his way through the floating city, items previously only available in the game's special editions. As for that long-awaited story DLC tied to the season pass, Irrational head honcho Ken Levine says it's still in development, and there's no timeline for its launch. Now, the past few months have seen a trickle of information on this mysterious DLC, which looks like it's going to be a new AI companion. But let's be honest, can anyone really hold a devil's kiss to Elizabeth's excellent programming? The career of former Square Enix president and CEO Yoichi Wada may have taken a phoenix down. Wada resigned from his position in May, but according to the official Square Enix website, he has now stepped into the role of chairman of the board. We've contacted our friends at Square and will share more details on his new position as we have them. The Xbox One base system will ship with a new Kinect when it launches later this year, but not with a headset. Tragedy, I know. Basic headsets for the Xbone will be available at retail when the console launches, just not packaged with the console. Microsoft said its decision to nix the headset was to emphasize voice input for the built-in Kinect. Xbox 360 headsets are not compatible with the new Xbone controllers, so you can't use those either. So, Plants vs. Zombies 2...
Actually, I've got this. So, Plants vs. Zombies 2 is delayed. Again. PopCap says the game will launch later this summer, as opposed to its initial release date of July 18th, because the game needs a little more sunshine and TLC before it's ready to live up to fans' expectations.
We reviewed the new Super Mario Bros. U add-on, New Super Luigi U. Our own Phil Kohler thought Luigi was faster, looser, and less precise than his more attention-hogging brother Mario. Luigi has been given a set of levels designed to be blown through as quickly as possible. The structure is the same as its parent game, but it's easily the most difficult Mario content that Nintendo has created in decades. It's a little nutty. We also spent some time with the Swapper, Facepalm Games' puzzle platformer for PC. Players must find their way off an abandoned, damaged space station with the help of a few clones. So it's basically Moon, the game. We liked both games. Check out the full reviews for more details. Damn you, Nabbit!
We spent some time with Christy Marks, an accomplished storyteller whose pedigree begins with Gem and G.I. Joe and ends with Zynga. Marks has written for cartoons, point-and-click adventures, board game role-playing games, and now she's providing the narrative backbone for dozens of social video games, as well as lending her pen to some DC comics. If you're interested in writing for games, this intimate look into one woman's journey to get there is for you.
Turner prices?
92. Whew, what a day. Stay cool, Polynauts.